Hello dear students of AT 20503. Welcome to this course, Industrial Revolution and Research Methodology, AT 20503. In Malay, it's called as Revolusi Industri dan Metodologi Penyelidikan. I am the coordinator for this section 4 for AT 20503. My name is Professor Fong Sun Fok, and you can call me Prof. Fong. From the Faculty of Social Sciences and Humanities, and I'm also attached to the Center for E-Learning. We are three group leaders in AT20503 for the program Komunikasi. Siti Nurhaliza binti Matruza is our chief leader. In the program Sociology dan Anthropology Social, we have Muhammad Ruzaidi bin Yusuf. And in the program Pentarasan Islam, we have Muhammad Izam bin Muhammad Safuan. In all this program, there are team leaders coordinating with your program leader. The attendance for this course will all, of course, be online for this semester. And I expect attendance of 100%. I know many of us might be affected by the connectivity issue. So make a attempt. Should you somehow be absent and not able to log in or to join in, then you must write an email with the subject of 8020503 absent. State your reason why you could not join. Send it to your program leaders. That is to Siti Nurhaliza for communication, Ruzaidi for ENSOS, and Izam for Islamic studies. Now, the evaluation for this 8020503 would be the following. There will be the first assignment. It's called as a research proposal. So each and every one of us individually will have to come up with a proposal. And this will be 25%. The details I will share with you in the next class. The second assignment is on literature review. Sorotan Literature. Now, this is a group work, okay, and it will be 25%. Then we have the group presentation of the in-depth literature review, which is be 20%, and there will be the quiz individually, 30%. It is like this. There are about 252 students in this course. Individually, all of you will have to do a research proposal. Then you will be within groups of 5 people to a group, and within the 5 people to the group, you look at your research proposal, the 5 research proposal by the 5 individuals there, and pick one particular one as the chosen proposal where you do a detailed literature review. So the 5 of them will now do the in-depth literature review on the one topic that is being chosen. Okay. Then later on, there will be the group presentation of this in-depth literature review by the 5 of you in that group. It's a group project. So there will be the quiz. I will go into the detail next week. This is Datin Paduka, Dr. Siti Hamisa binti Tafsir. And she was the former Director General for the Department of Higher Education. She has a book here called Framing Malaysian Higher Education 4.0 so that we can produce future-proof talents from our university. Now, this is what she said. It's meant for all university in Malaysia. We need to equip our graduate with future-proof skill sets by harnessing the humanistic, technological, and data analytic competencies in embracing the 4th Industrial Revolution. Lifelong learning must be embraced by all students through reskilling and upskilling opportunities. This book, by the way, is available in your Smart B3. In UMS, this is also our agenda, Transformation Towards University Industry 4.0. Masjid Arah University Industry 4.0. This is a cutting from a newspaper on 20th October, it's a few days ago, and there's a report from the Bloomberg Economics that states robots encroach on up to 800 million jobs around the world. Advances in automation technology, advances in Industrial Revolution 4.0 threatens a significant share of jobs in the industry. Even today, even before the COVID-19 pandemic, anyone of your family members became unemployed or were affected because of these machines. We shall start by looking at the IR 4.0 from the historical context. I assume that every one of you have gone into our learning management system, Smart V3. And over there, there is a video clip under the category of Industrial Revolution Introduction. So you must have gone through this short video, and there are forums available there. So you should have gone into your forum. If you are from Unsource, click Unsource, and then you will go in and give response to the questions that are in the forum. I assume that you have gone through this before coming into this class. So very briefly, I will go through again the historical context of Industrial Revolution. So there are four Industrial Revolution that have taken place, or is taking place. One that has been triggered by the steam innovation. So the first Industrial Revolution used water and steam power to mechanize production. Then the second one is to do with electricity, and it create mass production. The third one is to do with computing, where electronic and information technology came in to automate the mass production. And we are now in the fourth IR, quantification, which is characterized by a fusion of technologies, that is the physical, the digital, as well as the biological. This is summarized visually in this particular infographic. Briefly again, so the Industrial Revolution, the steam engine that affected bring in mechanical production. The steam engine, an engine that used hot steam from boiling water to drive the piston back and forth. And this engine was heavily used those days on the railroad to transport people from one place to another. The second revolution, mass production, assembly line, electricity, and it's also during this time that Henry Ford, the founder of Ford Motor, brought in the mass production of vehicles on land. During the second industrial revolution, some of the major inventions, for example, by Alexander Graham Bell, who invented telephone. And do you remember what was his first word when he used the telephone for the very first time? Hello. Hello. By the way, why did he mention hello? Try to find it out. Typewriters were also invented, and it helped the people to mass produce writing. The third industrial revolution, internet, computers, automated production came in. And also in this time, email was invented. And up there on the left-hand side, floppy disk, where data was stored and saved. Those were the beginning. When I started using computer, I bought my first computer called Apple IIe, and we make use of the big, we are in Industrial Revolution 4.0. And this phase is a boom in the internet and the telecommunication industry. And this Industrial Revolution 4.0, again, is a fusion of technologies that blur the line between the physical, digital, and biological sphere, making it significantly different from the IR 3.0. Now, Industrial Revolution, the word revolution denotes something abrupt, something radical, something significant. Okay, it's a big change. Revolution have occurred throughout history when new technologies and novel ways of perceiving the world trigger a profound change in the economic system. And given the history is used as a frame of reference, these changes may take years to unfold. In Germany, there were discussions about Industry 4.0, and this term was actually coined at the Hanover Fair in 2011 to describe how this will revolutionize the organization of global value chains by enabling something called smart factories. The Ford IR creates a world in which virtual and physical system of manufacturing globally cooperate with each other in a flexible way. And this enables the absolute customization of products and the creation of new operating models. Industrial Revolution, the government and public institutions, as well as the private sector, need to do their part. But it is also essential that citizens see the long-term benefit. Pengetahuan daripada First Industrial Revolution adalah masih valid pada masa kini, iaitu sejauh mana keupayaan masyarakat menguasai sesuatu inovasi teknologi adalah penentu kemajuan utama. There are megatrends in Industrial Revolution 4.0. Now, if you Google megatrend, you'll be able to see many more listed. So, for this course, we are looking at megatrends from the physical, digital, and biological area. What are megatrends? Megatrend adalah kekuatan global, mampan, dan pembangunan ekonomi makro yang memberikan impact kepada penjagaan ekonomi, masyarakat, budaya, dan kehidupan peribadi dengan menggambarkan dunia masa hadapan dan berdasarkan perubahan yang semakin translated to the English, megatrend is a global force. It's sustainable. It's a macroeconomic development that will impact business, economy, society, culture, personal life, almost every aspect, but envisioning the future world based on rapid changes. Megatrends in the field of physical. So physical trends are the easiest to see because they are tangible, right? Autonomous vehicles such as trucks, cars, drones, aircraft, and boats. Have you seen the drones? Small little helicopter-like flying around. Those are drones. Those are the mega trends of IR 4.0. Cars without a driver inside. Automatic cars, vehicles. Hey, they are already here. 3D printing. Additive manufacturing, using broad range of application from large turbine to small or medium implants. If you can go to the library, when it's open, okay, you will be able to see 3D printing. The printers are there. Okay? So you can design your very complex 3D materials, and then you take it over there, and it will print out a particular prototype for you. Advanced robotic, more adaptive and flexible, with advanced sensors, they can understand and respond in the better way. And in the industry, a lot of this advanced robotic, and that is where it is replacing humans to do very dangerous jobs, even accurately and more effectively. So they are, in a way, a threat to the employment of human beings in the industry. New materials that are lighter, stronger, recyclable, adaptive, smart are now in the physical megatrends of Industrial 4.0. In the digital aspect of megatrend, some of these trends are a bridge between physical and digital. IoT, Internet of Things, a relationship between things, products, services, places, and people. These days, you just take your phone and you call your phone to call a certain number, it can respond to you. What happened? Now, I want you to Google IoT, and it will come out a list of many products that have been invented and yet to be invented, okay? IoT is the future, dear students. Blockchain, new approaches for engagement and collaboration. Blockchain creates trust without a neutral central part. So later on, by the time you graduate, you may not be having your paper degree, okay? It might be blockchain, digital degree certificate. So there are new approaches. Once again, do Google and see what's the meaning of blockchain. In the next class, I'd like to ask you more concerning what is IoT and blockchain. Platforms, matching supply and demand in a very accessible way. From the biological megatrend standpoint, now, genome. Today, genome can be sequenced in a few hours, more than 10 years, and 2.7 billion euro to complete the Human Genome Project, for example. Do you know what is Human Genome Project? It's the project where, you know, in the cell, we have chromosomes, 23 pairs of them, and within the chromosome, along the chromosome, are genes. And genes are the one that actually determine how you look like, you know, how your ear look like, how you have your stomach, how your intestine, how your large intestine, how your kidney, how your heart, how your blood, your red blood cells, your white blood cells. Hey, would you believe it? Every part of you is actually determined by the genes along the chromosome. And those are the genome. That's the genome. So the Human Genome Project is actually one where they determine along the chromosome which part actually control the production of, let's say, the kidney, the hearty, okay, things like that. So these have got very important potential in the medical and pharmaceutical field. Synthetic biology, customizing organism by writing the DNA. Wow, synthetic biology. Biology, the study of life, okay? You can take the DNA, you can cut it up, and then you can take a portion of a DNA of the heart of the human being, example, and then you put it into the zygote of, let's say, the lembu. And just imagine, if it works out, the lembu, when it grows up, will be having the heart of a human being. And just imagine, if it is your DNA, your heart, then your that particular lembu or that particular kambing, the goat, okay, will be having your heart. And in future, when you somehow need to change your heart, you can take that particular goat, take out your heart from the goat, and then transfer it there. Hey, a lot of potential, a lot of future. But of course, there are a lot of ethical issues there. Data, meningkatkan ketepatan perubatan dengan terapi sasaran, kaedah perawatan. So, more of this, okay, that we will be discussing in future. The impact of these mega trends is on the economy, the business, so national, society, individuals. Let's have a look at them. What is the impact of industrial revolution, the mega trends on economy? Critical dimension, for example, on growth. Technology and innovation are at an inflection point and will soon unleash a surge in productivity with the mass production of with the use of electricity, later on with computing, and now with the industrial revolution, the growth will be exponential. Employment. New technologies will dramatically change the nature of work across all industries. New technologies are here. New technologies will be invented tomorrow, 1 month's time, 1 year's time, and it will dramatically change the nature of work across all aspects of it. All aspects. New skills, low-risk job in terms of automation will be those that require decision-making under uncertainty. Okay. So many jobs will be replaced by IR 4.0 innovation. Nature of work, workforce will do a portfolio of things to generate income. So the impact on the economy is going to be very profound. Dear students, I'd like you to Google, okay, and see impact of IR 4.0 on economy, and you'll be able to see a whole list of many, many more. And there are a lot of articles on all this. This is just a skeletal outline. Please go into detail by Googling to find out more. The impact on business, the aspect to understand is that customer expectation, data-enabled products, new collaboration, new operating models, all will be affected significantly. Disruptive changes are redefining how public institutions and organizations operate. In the old world, decision makers had enough time to study a specific issue and then create the necessary response. Technology will increasingly enable citizens, providing a new way to voice their opinion. Cities need to act like entrepreneurs. They have to compete in attracting talents. And all this will affect the national level and national issues and national affairs. The impact on society. The biggest challenge for society is how to absorb and accommodate the new modernity while still embracing traditional values. Of course, this should be of interest to students in UNSOS, isn't it? What happened to the cultural issues? What happened to religion? With all these mega trends of impact of 4.0. Belonging to a community today is more defined by personal project and individual's values rather than by spacious work or family. So one effect of digitalization is the emergence of the me-centered society. Some people are worried, concerned. People are becoming very self-centered, the me-centered society. Because in the digital world, you can be by yourself and you may be cut off from your social circle in the real world. So you become more self-centered. The me-centered society is there. Of course, some of you will be saying, you know, hey, my real friends are there in the digital world. The games that I play, 100 of them, those are my friends. Yes, those are your community. Yes. So, you know, new norms, new meaning of society. Now, do Google all this and get into the in-depth of this. The impact on individuals, not only changing what we do, but also who we are. So many people are concerned that it has a lot of impact upon our behavior, how you people are, especially you students, the way your behavior is today. Parents are concerned. Employers are concerned. The privacy, the ownership, the consumption, the time for work, the time for pleasure have been changed. 2 a.m., 3 a.m., many of you are still not sleeping. What are you doing? You will tell us it's our leisure time. It's the time where we play our games because our friends across the time zone is now awake. See? So, significantly, the impact upon individuals have changed. Please Google all this and look at it and also try to reflect how all these mega trends impact upon the program communication, upon the program of UNSOS, upon Islamic study, upon religion. 4.0 innovation respond to the COVID-19 pandemic. So, example, okay, I was looking at the newspaper. These are from the Star in 17 September. So, due to the present condition, okay, of the pandemic. So, here, Mitra the robot helps COVID patient in India speak to a loved one. A hospital in India deployed a customer service robot to patrol its ward in the hospital, connecting a coronavirus patient to friends and relatives. If somehow your relative members are in the hospital right now because of COVID-19, they were tested positive, you cannot visit them. And they are can be quite lonely, you know, can be quite lonely. But you can still communicate with them through the handphone. Or if you don't have a handphone, at least, you know, this service of the robot can visit them. The robot cannot be affected, of course, by the coronavirus. So you see, this is IR 4.0. Robot coming into play positively. Okay, the impact is really positive here. Robot don't sneeze. Hospital officers turning to delivery bots, robots during coronavirus pandemic. The next time you order hotel room service, you may receive a buzz on your phone rather than a knock on your door. These days, you know, we stay in the hotel before the pandemic. You can order food and then the people will come and serve you your food or makanan. But due to the pandemic, hey, how about using the robot to serve you food? How about the using the robot to attend to you at the counter? Robot with human in terms of predicting financial meltdown. So even in the financial world, the world of economic, it seems that the robot is able to have an edge over humans when it comes to predicting the next economic breakdown, meltdown. In Japan, soft banks are robotic arms, okay? Food service by the robot. especially these days, you know, because of the COVID-19 pandemic, such kind of innovation probably needs to be practiced in Malaysia. Maybe it needs to be practiced in UMS when you come back. Walmart, supermarket in America, they use drone to deliver the goods to the house. Again, this COVID-19 pandemic has brought in a lot of limitation that has disrupted our conventional living, our style of practices. So, hey, these drones are fantastic, isn't it? It's able to bring and deliver items for you from the shop or from the supermarket right to your house. Robot in the train station in London, moving around, killing coronavirus using ultraviolet light. Those cold booths, no humans need to be there. It's automated. Especially if you come from the Semenanjung, you're used to touch and go. And you just drive through, okay? Or just scan it. Robocop, David, COVID Robocop, that can remind people to wear their mask. They can detect and say, hey, you're not wearing a mask. Please wear your mask. Tolong pakai your mask. Human beings, when you remind people to wear a mask, some people may be angry because they choose not to wear. Okay? But this Robocop can politely remind them again and again. So, during this current situation, there are issues with regard to the danger of a coronavirus. So how could Industrial Revolution 4.0 come in as a solution? So I want all of you, dear students, to reflect in your field of communication, in the field of ANSOS, in the field of Islamic studies. What are the issues related to the field, your field? And how the megatrends of Industrial Revolution 4.0 can come in to solve it? Of course, you can Google and find out so many, many things that are already happening. Okay? So, this is your assignment. I call it assignment 3 because in the smart V3, you have already one assignment where you introduce yourself. Then the second assignment was where you have a response with regard to the video on Industrial Revolution. And now, this is assignment 3 in your smart V3. Search for one video or website or article concerning the effect of IR 4.0 on any aspect related to your program. It must be your program. Okay? So, state briefly the positive effect as well as the negative effect. Now, in Smart V3, where do you give this response? You go to the blog Industrial Revolution, Industrial Revolution Introduction, where there is the video and also the forum, isn't it? So click your respective program and then click in your respective team. It's all in the forum. And then click reply on your own previous post. All of you have stated and give comment, okay, with regard to that particular video. So now you click reply there. And you share. If it is a video, you click the link and then you enter the URL in the particular window that appear. Click create link, post to forum, and the YouTube video, for example, will be displayed over there, okay? Or if some of you may want to share an article, an animation, anything, okay? That is related to an effect of IR 4.0 megatrends on any aspect related to your communication or your answers or your Islamic study. Now, after that, when you have done it, you do it within the particular team, okay? Your team, you got about 10 people in the particular team, so share it there. And I want every one of you, we need a team, to go and visit the one that had been sent by your friend, okay, and give a comment. Now, through this exercise, you will be able to have an archive of so many good examples that have been curated by your friend. Dear students, this is the new norm. This is the community of learners. All of us now become a member of this community. Okay, so mutually we support one another by doing the way that I've instructed. There are other tutorials that I've listed over here, and these tutorials will be discussed with you with your tutors. Your tutors will be with you during the Minggu Keempat, during the fourth week.